Power 904, giving it to you straight.
You are now tuning into the Smokey Burrow Show, keeping it hot like fire and giving it to you straight on Power 904.
All right, this your girl Smokey with the Smokey Burrow Show. I got my homeboy Poppy Stores on the line. Poppy, what's good?
You still? I'm chilling. You already know. In the building.
That's what's up. That's what's up, man. So just recapping on everything. It was a good time seeing you. We chopped it up in the studios, our studios, NYC. You and the legendary rapper Cassidy making a track, man. Just tell us a little bit about that.
Oh, man, that was a pleasure. Like, I've been rapping with Cassidy forever. I'm saying, but honestly, this is our first time actually throwing a song together. Now, man, so it was like, it was dope. And the way it happened, it was so organic. Like, it wasn't like, yo, send me the beat, whatever, I write it is, do that. Nah, we didn't even have no plans to do that song. We just went to the studio. We was all like quiet, chilling, vibing. And then Dwayne the Rock played the beat and said, "Stores, right from to this." Boom. I didn't even know Cassidy was going to be on it. Then Cassidy comes. Boom. He jumps on it. Threw it off from the Lords of the Underground was in the building. He jumped on it. You know what I'm saying? And the way I did it, I wasn't even going to get on the record. Cause I usually don't make records for females. Like, I don't do, like, female songs. I just make, you know, lyrical records, music, you know, substance and messaging my songs. And, I mean, I'm a different type of, I mean, MC. So I wasn't going to get on it. It wasn't my type of vibe. But then at the last minute, something came over me and said, "You better get on this record." Like, opportunities like this don't just come every day.
Right. I saw you in the corner, serious.
Well, so I was like, all right. And, you know, every time when I rhyme, and I know I'm getting on records with other guys, I'm saying, I'm going to make sure my verse stands out. So I knew I was going to kill it. So once, you know, I wrote my verse in like five minutes, maybe four, and I went in there and laid it down, 2 seconds there, and it was just a blessing.
That was a done deal. That was a done deal, man. Exactly. That brings me into my question I wanted to ask you. Like, who was the first person to put a mic in your hand? Like, how old were you? Like, what brought you into this game?
Oh, the first person to put a mic in my hand was me, because the first time I started recording, I went to the 99 Cent store, and I bought me a, like, bootleg microphone that was from, like, 99 Cent, and I plugged it into my little stereo system I had in the house. And then I took two tapes and I put them in there and I started recording myself. You know, one was playing the beat. The other one was recording my voice on the mic and the beat while I was rapping. So that's how I started. I mean, just, you know, just playing around, trying to make songs, see if I could make a tape. Back then we had CDs, we had tapes. And that's how I first started. I mean, but what made me, like, fall in love with the music, like, was watching videos on Video Music Box. I used to call on my house line and order the video, like, "Oh, press 2111 now." 4321 with Redman, LL Cool J, and Method Man. You know what I'm saying? And all that.
Right. So, man, who do you listen to? Like, who do you listen to? Like, who you grew up listening to? Who do you listen to right now? Like, who's hot to Poppy right now?
Police, ambulance. But anyway, we live doing it. You know what I'm saying?
We live right now. It's hot on the Smokey Bones Show like that.
Yes. So what I listen to is Nas, AZ. I came up listening to Jay-Z, Coochie Rap, Rock Him, KRS-One, LL Cool J, Slick Rick. What I listen to presently to this day, it's still Nas and Jay. I listen to Joe Budden, Slaughterhouse, Joell Ortiz. I had an opportunity to do music with Joell Ortiz. I know Joe Budden. I know the whole Slaughterhouse, Royce the 5'9". You know what I'm saying? Like, but I listen to guys like that. Like, you know what I'm saying? I don't really listen to too much of the other type of stuff. I mean, like, I like to listen to music with a substance, with a message. Something that relates to what I do, like hip hop. So, you know, as far as the new guys, like, I listen to Votto, or I listen to Meek Mill. I rock with Meek. Who else?
Nice.
That's about it. As the new guys, Meek, Wale's dope. What else can I say? I mean, that's about it as far as new guys, but I still listen to, you know, old records from back in the day, Wu-Tang. I listen to Redman still. Redman dropping new stuff nowadays. I listen to the new Wu-Tang stuff that come out. Stuff like that.
Absolutely. Now, I was checking you out. You know, I follow you on your Instagram page, Poppy Stores, you know, on Instagram. And I noticed, you know, you were promoting royalfamilyfilms.com. Tell us a little bit more about that. What you got going on, Poppy Stores?
Oh, yeah, well, royalfamilyfilms.com is the actual website. They don't belong to me. It belongs to the director of the two movies I'm on, King of Newark and The Fearless One. So that's where you can actually go watch the two movies I'm on. You can go to the website and rent it for like $5 a pop, and you can check your boy out in my films that I'm on, like with other well-known actors such as Austin Powell. You got Mano, Votto. These are artists. A whole bunch of different actors in there, man, but yeah, I had a great opportunity to work with these guys. So if y'all get a chance, log on to that website and, you know, try to support. It's only $5, so you get both movies to spend. You know what I mean?
Definitely. And could you give us a brief synopsis? Let me tell you about one of your characters in the film or, you know, something what the movie is about. Just give us a little taste.
Yeah, well, like in The King of Newark, basically I'm playing myself, like I'm Poppy Stores in that movie, and I'm just on the street hustling, you know, working with Votto, you know what I'm saying, and going to war with the main character, you know what I'm saying, so it's just dope, like, it's dope, I'm out here moving bricks and all that, I'm on some gangster shit, part of my life.
I'm so gangster shit, I hear you, all right, so I mean, that brings me to my next question, What is Poppy Stores passionate about? Like, what do you enjoy doing, you know? What can't you stop thinking about?
Music. Like, I mean, well, acting right now is kind of taking over because there's a new passion of mine that I just started. I've only been rocking doing movies for, like, maybe 2 to 3 years, maybe. If not, maybe four.
Okay.
But I've been doing music all my life. The music actually opened the doors for me to get in these films. Because if it wasn't for music, I would have never met, like, the director Alonzo. I wouldn't have met other directors I worked with and all that. So I'm just real passionate about anything and everything that I do. If my heart's in it, I'm passionate. I'm going to go hard at everything that I do. But if my heart's not in it, then, you know, I ain't going to do the shit. So, you know.
True that, I hear that. Definitely, I can definitely relate to that, you know, look past this kid growing up in the South, you know, the drums, piano, church, the choir, you know, just music is in my veins too, so I definitely feel you there about the passion. And, you know, just wanted to know from you, you being a young legend in New Jersey, you know, doing the thing, what would you say to the kids right now, the children out there who are coming up, who want to be a young legend such as yourself, who want to be in the music, who want to be in film, you know, who want to be just more than a one-hit wonder, what would you say to them, what would you say to the kids?
Well, what I would say is just keep going and stay focused and don't let nothing stop you. If you really want to be what you want to be, you got to go hard every day. Like, see, I eat, sleep, and shit, this music stuff, or anything that I do for that matter. Like, you just got to go hard and let nobody stop you or derail you from your goals and from your mission. If you stay passionate, stay dedicated, work hard, you definitely got to work hard. Don't sit there and wait for opportunities, create them. Like, that's what I do. I always motivate myself. I don't have no team. I don't have a whole bunch of people promoting me. I don't got a whole bunch of goons standing behind me and doing a whole bunch of, like, I mean, I don't got nothing. It's just me. And I've been accomplishing a lot my whole career alone. So just imagine, like I tell the young guys, like, just imagine if I had, you know, the backing that a lot of these guys have, or the gang-related stuff. All this stuff that these guys have to get to the next level. Like, I don't have that. So, and I'm accomplishing big things without it alone. No team, no management, no big budgets, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of my stuff been happening for me just off of relationships alone and people just liking my aura and the energy that I bring around. Yeah. Like, you bring around good aura and good energy and be humble, dude. And then if you got music to back it up, like, if you really talented, they can't deny the talent. And the music, that's how I work with a lot of the industry guys. Once they heard my music, it's like, yeah, I want to work with you. They start following me. They start supporting. You know what I'm saying? They don't ask for a dollar. So it's just like blessings on blessings. And every opportunity that presents itself, just take it. I tell them, take it. Like, don't limit yourself. If you want to do music, then do music. If music leads you to clothing, do the clothing. Don't say no. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's how I met a lot of the guys that I rock with now. Like, I do music, and then they be like, yo, I got a clothing line. Yo, you mind wearing my shirt? Nah, hell no. Go give me the shirt. I put it on. I put it in my, and always be humble and always show love. Like, never be the type that'd be, like, too big or make yourself feel like you better than somebody. Or don't be stingy with your blessings. Like, all the blessings that I got, I bring my people on from the hood. Like, a lot of my friends, I know they're from the streets. So when I try to give them something different, like, you know what I'm saying? I don't ask for nothing. A lot of people come to me and ask me for stuff. I don't be, like, thinking in my mind, like, oh, what can I gain out of this person coming to me? No, I don't think with that type of mentality. I be like, if I got it and I can give it to you and it can help you out, then I'm going to give it to you. I'm not no guy that's be like, that's why maybe one of the reasons why I'm still in the same position I'm in is because I don't think selfishly and I don't look for gain. A lot of people tell me, yo, you be having all these connects. And you just giving away to people. Like, you need to start charging motherfuckers. And I'm like, for what? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if we keep thinking like that, our people is never going to be able to elevate. We're supposed to help each other. Like, we ain't supposed to just keep everybody stagnant. Like, it's enough. Like, I'm confident with my talents. I'm confident with my grind. I'm never intimidated by nobody. So if I feel like there's another rapper that's nice, I'm not going to be scary like, oh my God, he might take my spot. No, I'm already probably still. You can't take my spot. Like, I'm me already. So I'm going to help. If I think you're nice, I'm going to do a record with you. I'm not going to charge you. I'm not going to do this. I'm not. If you call me and stay your stores, I'm saying, yo, I need this. Can you hook me up with? Because a lot of people know I know a lot of people. Big people. So they'd be like, yo, I want to meet Jada, so I want to do this, I want to do that. I tell them, I'm like, come on, just give me a ride, and we all roll out together. I'm saying, the only downfall to that is you're going to get a lot of leeches and a lot of people that's going to, like, take advantage of you. And, you know, I go through this every day. Like, every day I get done wrong, I get taken advantage of, and then once people get what they want out of me, like, they don't break bread, or they don't, like, they get to the where they need to be, they never reach back and give me an opportunity or alley-oop. Like, yo, I got this movie over here, or I got this record, I'm going to do a song with this guy, and I might not know the guy. It might be like, let's say somebody did a song with Drake, and I helped them get there, right? They're not going to reach back and be like, yo, I'm about to do this song with Drake. You want to come to the studio with us? No, they would never reach back. I'm about to do a video with Drake. You want to come be in a video? No, they'll never reach back. And I'm not saying Drake. I'm just using an example. I'm saying that I've been in situations like that where I plug people with people, and then when they go do the music or do the video, they don't even reach out. Like, and they excuse me like, oh, yo, I forgot, bro. I've been busy running around trying to get everything done. I forgot about you. But you didn't forget about me when you called me to get introduced to the person. Like, it's a lot of grimy stuff, but that never stopped me or made me change the type of character I am, because I don't hold envy and grudges. Like, I don't know how to be malice. Like, I don't know. And people tell me I need to be like that. It's like, in order to make it in this game, you gotta be cutthroat. And if you're not cutthroat, you're not gonna last. And I've been lasting. I've been lasting on my own way. God's been lasting.
Exactly.
Exactly. God blesses me, and I stay humble, and I keep winning it. And if I'm making it, I don't make it, at least I know that I've accomplished a few things and I got further than what I should have on my own. I'm saying, and I'm thankful for what I got. And, you know, It is what it is. I'm just enjoying the moment.
It is what it is. Hey, that's what's up. You guys, this is Poppy Stores on the Smokey Bell Show. I hope you guys enjoy that, Poppy. What I want to do with you, I'm about to throw this out to you. This is a segment that we're going to be doing on the Smokey Bell Show. It's going to be called the Wild Card Segment. You ready for this, Poppy?
I'm ready for it, baby girl.
All right.
It's time for the wild card question, baby.
So, let's see. Your question on the wild card segment is going to be, what is your favorite 16 bars from one of your favorite songs or any of any artist or any of your songs that you have done, and can you rap it for us?
Oh, damn, you put me on a spot with that.
We can pause it.
No, don't pause nothing. We're going to keep it straight raw. Let me see, 16 bars. Hold on. Oh, man, I'm trying to think because I got so many different artists running through my mind right now, even my own music. I'm trying to think, like,
It's a wild card, like a mug
right now. You're killing me.
Man, we got to thank Lady Tory for that one. Lady Tory Power 904.
Yeah, let me see what I got. You know what? My brain is going all over.
I got another one for you. We can pause. Let's see. You have a new single you just put out? When you got a new song you got out?
Yeah, I actually got a new joint that I just did. It's a freestyle with DJ Drewski from Hot 97. It's called What Jersey Looks Like. It's on my on my SoundCloud, Real Poppy Stores SoundCloud. The link is in my bio on Instagram. So make sure y'all follow me there. PAPISTORZ Poppy Stores. You see?
All right. So what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna give you number two. This is gonna be question number two. All right, on the Smokey Bell Show, this is the Wild Card segment, Poppy Stores. So your question of the day is going to be, give us a live taste of your new single and tell us about it when you're done.
All right, well, my new single, the name of the album is called Trapped in the 90s. So my Trapped in the 90s niggas, but the song is called Trapped in the 90s. And it's basically a record bringing back all the things from the 90s, like not everything, but a majority of it, like how the feeling was in the 90s, hip hop, the clothes we used to wear, the things we used to do, like it's a dope feeling. And I actually leaked it. It's one of the singles, is my first single off my new project called Trapped in the 90s. It's called 1999, you know what I mean? And
okay.
On my SoundCloud, Real Poppy Stores, everything's on SoundCloud, so y'all go check that out. It's very dope. And I got a sample on there of Nas, and he was like, Nas be saying, for my Trapped in the 90s niggas, I'm saying, I was like, as far as the bars go, I said, brand new, like, I'm going to do y'all one solid, but if you want bars, I can give you
that
bars.
That's that real artist, that freestyle. You guys make sure you go check it out, Real Poppy Stores on SoundCloud, that's right, Real Poppy Stores?
Yes. So if y'all want bars, I can give you bars. If you want me to spit, I'll
give
spit.
Us some bars. Just give us some bars. Some bars for us. Give us
some
freestyle.
All right, I'm going to just, this is a taste to let y'all know what I'm working with. I said, listen to the kid as I make a statement. I got kicked out the game because my fouls was flagrant, but still balling. Smelling like expensive fragrance. Bazooka Joe bubblegums, edible laces, far from local. Dog, I've been to all places. I chill with celebrities and still I'm not famous. Had all types of chicks from thin to thick waists. Haitians, Dominicans, ran through all races. Man, y'all all basic. Stop being lame. It's the boy Stores Homes. Yup, watch for the name. I'm known when it comes to the flames. Since Jesus left, pray tonight and thank God that I came. It's only right that I reign. See, this the takeover. Stores, a.k.a. the flamethrower. BSB, full clips, my click. Remain soldier, stay around blunts and licks. I couldn't remain sober. Cats is corn muffin. He can't be all bluffing. My slab alone nothing. I pop, you hold something. Dog, you broke frontin'. Those cats I can't follow. Ma, you still frontin'. Don't ask and just swallow. Son, your hoes bald. I be handling them down. You cuffing them and loving them. I pass them around. At the bar, might pass them around. Get them loose and early. After that, she just asked to go down. Don't ask to throw down, because I don't want to fist fight. But I will if I have to, though I'd rather get hyped. Hold on. Though I'd rather get pipes. Don't have me get hyped, because I'll pop with ease. Aim at your head and turn your brain to nacho cheese. See, you a shooting star. I'm a shooting star. You aiming for the sky. Fuck you try to shoot a star. You better wish to a shooting star that I don't get heated enough to pull out and shoot a star. I got stupid bars, so just cool it. I can keep my neck froze. I threw my chain in the cooler box. I might stop, but still stupid hot. May act dumb at certain times, but stupid I'm certainly not. I'm trying to earn my spot spitting these raps. See, I'm known from hood to hood from battling cats. I earn my title. Ain't no one can knock me from that. I'm in the hood with no job. My whole purpose is to rap. Spit a verse and fans clap. They loving how I rip it. Spit a verse and get clapped, because you lying through your lyrics. Dog, pop is the illest. I'm quite influential. Freestyles make rappers go home and pick up a pencil. Dog, I will end you right off the top. We can do this in your hometown, city, or block. Take your chick with me. Have her ass swallowing cock with no keys to my hotel. She popping the lock. Tag it.
Yes, that's Poppy Storrs, P-A-P-I-S-T-O-R-Z on Instagram. Make sure you go add him. Make sure you go add him on SoundCloud. Real Poppy Storrs. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for dropping this fire freestyle on this Smokey Bro show. I appreciate it, man. I appreciate it.
Yes, yes. Anytime, anytime. I got more, but I ain't going to keep going. That's just
oh. I definitely appreciate it, man. Guys, make sure you go and check him out. Thank you for tuning in. Poppy Storrs, thank you for coming on, doing this interview with us. Guys, this is not going to be the last you hear from him. Anything you want to say to the people, Poppy?
Yeah, just make sure y'all support the real hip-hop. Support a good brother coming up doing this thing. You know, follow me on Instagram, P-A-P-I-S-T-O-R-Z. I keep saying it mad times because people will mess up my name and spell the wrong thing. Y'all can Google me, check out my videos on YouTube. Y'all can follow my brother too, you know what I'm saying? He got his clothing line popping, So Fitful. What's your Instagram? I'm saying at So Fitful, FitFulLLC. At So Fitful. Yeah, and the soul is SOUL. So Soul Fitful _LLC. I mean, so come get fly with us, man.
All right, come get fly, guys. Thank you for tuning in. This is the Smokey Bro Show on Power 904. Giving it to you straight, and we out.
Thank you for tuning into the Smokey Bro Show. Tune in next time on Power904.com.